Pyroluria can cause lifelong anxiety and depression, as noted in this video clip by Joan Matthews Larson. Hi, this is Larry Hobbs at FatNews.com. She notes that pyrroles are worthless byproducts of red blood cell production. She notes that most people have few of these in their blood, but some people have elevated levels, which causes problems. She did a study of people that who came to her clinic, and she found that pyrroles were elevated in 11% of normal people, 25% of disturbed children, 30% of schizophrenics, 40% of psychiatric patients, and 50% of alcoholics. She also notes that these percentages are actually conservative, where she found actually higher percentages than this in alcoholics and psychiatric patients, but conservatively, these are the percentages. She notes that pyrroles cause a loss of vitamin B6 and zinc, and it is this deficiency of B6 and zinc which is what causes the anxiety and depression. She says a lack of vitamin B6 leads to a deficiency of dopamine and serotonin, which is what causes the anxiety and depression. So then she goes on to give 11 signs. She actually doesn't talk about this in the video. I think it's because of lack of time, but you see the slide, but I spell it out here so that you can see it better. So signs of pyroluria, physical signs. Number one, do you have white spots or flecks on your fingernails? Number two, do you have opaquely white or tissue paper thin nails? Number three, are you a nail biter? Number four, do you have poor dream recall or nightmares? Number five, are you becoming a loner as you age? Number six, do you experience nausea or prefer not to eat breakfast? Number seven, does your face sometimes look swollen while under a lot of stress? Number eight, have you been anxious, fearful, or felt a lot of inner tension since childhood, but you've successfully hidden this from other people? Number nine, do you have bouts of depression and or nervous exhaustion? Number 10, as a child, did you get a stitch in your side as you ran? And finally, number 11, do you tend to focus internally on yourself rather than on the external world? So she notes that pyrroles can be measured with a simple urine test, and I will read the address and phone number out loud in case somebody has a sight impairment. It's the BioCenter Lab at 3100 North Hillside in Wichita, Kansas. Zip code is 67219. The phone number is 316-684-7784. And the person to talk to there is Jim Jackson, who is a PhD. She also notes that the urine must be sent properly or else you are wasting your time. Please be aware that if you ask your doctor about this, my guess is they will tell you this is complete and utter nonsense. But what they're really saying is, I know nothing about this, therefore I assume it is nonsense. As the Nobel Prize-winning chemist Linus Pauling said, when your colleagues aren't up on it, they're down on it. Remember, when they figured out that bacteria causes most ulcers, most doctors said this is complete and utter nonsense. Remember when they figured out that homocysteine was an independent risk factor for heart disease? Most scientists said this is complete and utter nonsense. Remember when they told doctors to wash their hands before delivering babies because there was something invisible on their hands that was infecting these mothers? Most doctors said this is complete and utter nonsense. So just realize that if your doctor tells you this is complete and utter nonsense, realize where they're coming from. If you're a doctor, please test this theory for yourself. Take your next 100 psychiatric patients, send their urine in to be tested. If they have elevated levels, give them zinc and B6 according to the protocol that Dr. Larson and other doctors are using. And by the way, they use very high doses of vitamin B6 and they give it multiple times during the day. And test your patients and see if it helps them. Please realize that if pyroluria is causing your anxiety and depression, antidepressants like Prozac and Zoloft cannot possibly help because they don't have anything to do with this. So here is the video clip of Joan Matthews Larson talking about this in a speech she gave in September 2007.
Let's talk about pyroluria for a little while. That's a worthless, pyroles are a worthless byproduct of the red blood cell synthesis. And very few people have many, if any, pyroles. Can you wait just a minute till I get through? Thank you. Some of us, however, are not so fortunate. Oh, Sorry. I thought you were asking a question. Okay. So, and here's just a, you have that list of, or shows how many people are. Because alcoholics, sometimes, one time we sat and counted how many at health recovery at that point were pyroluric, and it turned out to be 75%. You know, at least 40-50% all the time. So look for it in alcoholics. It's fairly common. And without treatment, these people are going to want to drink again because alcohol makes them feel social, gives them some energy, takes away their anxiety. And then it's the human condition to pursue whatever helps. So, all right, so we'll skip over some of this. But there is a test that you can get for it that is just a urine test that isn't invasive. Mark, can you go ahead to the testing? Right, okay. So call the BioCenter lab. I know that they even deal directly with a client or with a professional that isn't a doctor. They will send out the lab, the mailing boxes, and Dr. Jim Jackson will explain to you how to do the test. And because it has to be sent properly or you're just wasting your time. We send it in dry ice, and that's important.